natural impulse is to think that the balloon would act like any other solid object. When you accelerate, it would move back the same way that your body moves back in the seat. Well, take a look at this. Actually, when you accelerate, the balloon moves forward. And when you brake hard, it moves back. And in fact, when you turn sharply, the balloon actually turns towards the center of the turn. Now, to answer this interview question successfully, you not only have to know that, but you have to be able to explain why it is. Well, here's a good approach. The balloon is really like the bubble in a spirit level, one of those things that carpenters use to check whether a shelf or a floor is level. Now, the bubble is really, you know, a low-density hole in this denser liquid. And that causes it to do pretty much the opposite of what you'd expect when the level is tilted or even when it's accelerated. And that's pretty much true of the balloon as well. The balloon is essentially a hole in the air inside this sealed container, which happens to be your car. So whenever you accelerate, the heavier air moves back towards the back seat, and that air forces the lighter balloon forward towards the windshield. I'm William Poundstone, and if you're interested in finding a job or just like testing your wits, the name of my book is Are You Smart Enough to Work at Google?